My name is Rob. I play piano and guitar with Balmorhea.
Hi, Michael with Balmorhea. We're talking about our new record, Pendant World.
Yeah, so the origins of the name Balmorhea come from now a long time ago when Mike and I first met and started playing together. We were both pretty young and we were looking for a name for the band, and we went to this place. It's the name of a town in West Texas. It's called Balmorhea. And in the town, there's a big natural spring. It's this huge spring in the middle of the desert with the Davis Mountains as the backdrop. And we brought our guitars and were playing music together. And I think just had a moment where it felt like the right fit. Something about this, the physical place, the like oasis nature of that place felt like reflective of what kind of music we were making.
We met in 2001, I believe, in the summer in Southwest Texas. There's this summer camp that a lot of people from Rob's hometown and from where I went to university worked as counselors, and it's like a summer camp. So there's kids come for a couple weeks at a time and these counselors, and we met through that. So we both worked at the summer camp and we realized we had a similar kinship with our aesthetic of the music we liked and the music that we were both playing. So Rob had a bunch of songs that he had, and I had some songs as well. And when we first became friends, we started playing music together and adding piano to my songs and adding a second guitar to some of Rob's songs. And it just really, it was truly organic and fell into place without much effort.
Throw your mind back, like it feels like a lifetime ago. We were really almost, I think of ourselves as having been almost children when we first met and started making music together. And I think that in some ways, like that ethos has remained central in a way. I mean, obviously we've both grown up and we have different perspectives and we're adults, and but there's something still about that kind of carefree approach that we formed this band around when we were young that I think remains kind of at the center of what we try to do. The quote that's included in the artwork is from a book called Heaven's Breath by a scientist and philosopher named Lyell Watson. But in some ways that quote refers to the wind, which is a metaphor obviously from the previous album, and it kind of continued through on Pendant World. Pendant World is kind of like an icon or an image, something that is suspended in midair, also something that is valuable, like a necklace or a pendant, a jewel. And so there's something about that image that felt right in this collection of songs.
The artwork for Pendant World is predominantly a photograph taken by an American photographer named Dylan Hausthor. It was taken in Martha's Vineyard, which is off the coast of Maine in the northeast of the United States. And it features a very large spider web. I believe it's at dawn with a flash, with the kind of the foliage around it and kind of a bay with a mountain shrouded in fog. It's just a very evocative black and white large format photograph that Dylan made. And we were very happy that he actually already knew our music and owned some of our records. And so he was happy to collaborate with us on it. And I don't know, there's something about, there's kind of like an intensity and brutality in this like, this gothic web amidst this kind of like floral scene, all kind of shrouded in mystery with kind of these clouds in the background. It just really felt like the right kind of tandem of dark and light and this balance of these like opposing natures.
Immediately we were kind of connected with this photograph because in some ways this music as well is about like, you know, beauty and fragility and suffering and kind of like the juxtaposition, I guess, of those two ideas and how those can simultaneously exist. Concepts that are so unconcrete can be transmitted. So we were attracted to that image kind of immediately. I love that photograph and I'm glad that it's representing the album.
We recorded Pendant World in southern Vermont in the northeast of the US in a near town called Guilford. It's called Guilford Sound. Our producer and engineer, Jonathan Lowe, had worked there previously. The owner kind of has this off the grid green, everything's beautifully constructed and extremely thoughtful. The materials and the property, a 400-acre farm, which he restored two of the old dwellings and has a beautiful new home for artists to stay in. And then the studio is just completely, everything is acoustically kind of perfect sounding. The place where the artists stay is about a 20-minute walk from the studio. You cross over a creek on these giant stones and everything's covered in moss, and it's just I don't know, it's waking up and walking 20 minutes through a maple forest over moss pathways into this beautiful studio. It's quite an inspiring place to be and to make music.
This record, Pendant World, it develops on some themes that we started exploring with the wind. I'd say primarily those themes are musical. There's some voicing, some chord progressions, some exploration of certain types of settings that we have continued to explore in a new way with Pendant World that we did on the wind. For example, one little piece in, I think it's the third track on the album, Pendant World, there's the sound of a wind chime that we had made to be in the same chord as one of the songs, Le Vagabond from the Wind. So we've taken this kind of what is an important chord from that first album, and we've set it in a new way. We recorded the chime out in the middle of the forest, so you can kind of hear the setting of this certain chord in the physical place that we were recording. So that's kind of one little example of how there are musical ideas that were brought from the wind in Pendant World.
One thing we always try to do is retain our core kind of sound, if you will, our signature, whilst adding and pushing the envelope, expanding into different instruments and different territories that we previously haven't explored, one being sampled audio. So we used a lot of samples on this recording that we made. There's a lot more rhythmic elements. We mapped out beats and then had a percussionist play a drum kit over the beat, so we have both synthetic and the acoustic human element kind of fused into one. We added some brass and woodwinds, and there's a lot of wordless vocals throughout that kind of all blend together while retaining the core of the piano, string, guitar, kind of triad as like the bass of the material. We're hoping we could create something that is tangible and viscerally interesting and emotional, emotive. We imparted some of the peaceful forest into this recording so people can kind of get away.
First song on the album is called Nonplussed. That's one of the songs that we used a manipulated sample. It's kind of the first time that we have used audio in that way. And I think as we came out of the wind, which was really exploring acoustic instruments kind of in their pure form, I wanted to like subvert that a little bit, I guess, and try in my way to manipulate audio. So that song was kind of built in it, and it kind of modulates in tempo up and down, and it kind of sets the stage for the album.
Range is one of my favorite songs. It's a very short song. There's just two sections, and it comes in and out. It's a guitar-based song. Rob composed the guitar part, and we live four states apart from each other, so I was trying to learn this song from afar. So he recorded a video of himself playing it for me to play the other guitar, and it was very, very strange. I don't know what you made it hard for me. I spent literally a full day over and over and over before I sort of played it cleanly. Now I've got it on my fingers, remember it now, but it's kind of an interesting song. It's again features Sam Gendel on saxophone, and it's beautiful. It's one that gets stuck in my head a lot.
There's a Western energy, like a Texas kind of sound. Nonplussed has this sound range. Clearly that title kind of is evocative of that.
Held is a guitar-based song, electric guitar with strings. There's a really lush, deep organ pad underneath. And then there's this really soft piano that Rob brings in. It has a very kind of Lynchian quality to it, in my mind, David Lynch, that is, that it kind of feels like it's from a different era in some way. It has like a little bit of a lullaby quality, and the word held kind of just, it's very tender and kind of gentle and kind of just moves back and forth and glissandos between these two chords of the strings with like a really slow draw between coming back and forth. It's kind of a palate cleanser, if you will, in the sequence of the album. After some intense rhythms and stuff, you get a breather with that one to kind of reset as you finish the album out.
This was one of Michael's primary compositions, and when we were working on it in the studio, he kept performing it live, and kind of like we kept listening back and thinking like, no, this isn't quite hitting like in the same
we
way
tried,
that the
like,
demo
six
is.
Six or seven different guitars.
Yeah, and we would leave it and come back to it like you do sometimes, and then finally John was like, well, I mean, if what you have in the demo is the energy that you want, why don't we just use it, let's reamp it. So the performance on the album is actually very much you performing this, playing the song kind of just for yourself, and that's actually what found its way onto the album. So I think it has a really innocent and kind of pure energy that I think, I'm glad that John suggested that we do that, because I think it worked out nicely. You know, you kind of set out at the beginning and you maybe make a list of people who you think you might want to collaborate with from the very beginning. Sam and his music and the energy that he kind of represents was something that I was super attracted to and wanted to try to collaborate with. So I think we feel really lucky that he was willing to kind of like come on board with this a little bit. And then, yeah, and Joseph Shabason, as like Mike mentioned, he did the rework of our song Le Vagabond, but I loved so much what he did with that song. It felt like completely, it was like respectful and like completely new. And so I think particularly after that, we were like, we have to bring him into the world, because this is the type of energy that we are trying to explore with Pendant World. And then Aisha and Clarice, the string players, just they brought so much perspective and beauty to this project. We're super grateful to everybody who helped make this. I have been struck recently about how, for me, as a musician, as a music fan and lover, how kind of like music can seemingly from any place reach in, just like grab me and take me like I was sitting at a bar last night and there was a guy playing piano live in this bar, and it was like it reached into me and like took hold of my attention, and I've become more aware of the way in which music can really do that, like grab you and kind of take you out of your existence. And I think it's so powerful the way in which music can reach across time, it can reach across a room, it can reach across all kinds of dimensions, and it can kind of like pull you. So I hope that also this music has the ability to maybe reach out and grab somebody who may not be familiar with our music. Like maybe this will be the first time that they come to it, and that's the goal, I guess.
Pendant World sounds really good. Jonathan Lowe, the producer and engineer, is an absolute genius in that world, and so having him, we've made the wind with him as well, so we're kind of like this unit now where everything clicks and sounds wonderful. So CD and vinyl and digital, whatever format is your flavor, like I think you'll be pleased.